Welcome back to the Ed Show and the battleground story tonight. Well, Sarah Palin is proving yet again what a pathetic political grandstander she actually is. Palin's tagging along with Franklin Graham on a trip to Haiti, pretending to care about the victims of the deadly earthquake. What a phony. You know, I don't believe she gives a damn about anybody in Haiti. All she cares about is one person, herself. If she really wants to help out the needy, she should start right here in her own country and helping out millions of suffering Americans who are out of work and unemployed. Instead, she tweeted this. Thank yous to Jim DeMint for saying that he won't support any tax deal that includes help for the unemployed. Palin kicks unemployed Americans when they're down, but expects us to believe that she cares about the people in Haiti. The Haiti earthquake happened 11 months ago, but she's just now getting around to getting down there to make a visit because she really cares about those people. I tell you what, when she has a new book out and a reality show on TV, she is exploiting people who are suffering for media attention, for money, and for her own political gain. This is what she's all about. I think it's repulsive. For more, let's bring in Mike Papantonio, host of the nationally syndicated Ring of Fire radio show. Mike, good to have you with us tonight. Have we ever seen a bigger phony in contemporary time in American politics? I mean, she just lays it right out there as if we're not going to connect the dots.
Palin is addicted to the camera the same way that Paris Hilton is. It's almost a sickness. It doesn't make any difference how negative the attention is, as long as it's attention. It is, in a sense, an illness. Week one, she's clubbing halibut to death on her TV show in front of the camera so she can get some attention there. Next week, she's shamelessly showing her kind of corn-pon nature on TV when she tells us that North Korea is our ally. The point is this. It takes time and effort to create a public image for yourself that's equivalent of part Flavo Flav, part Katie Gosselin, and part Lindsay Lohan, but she's pulling it off pretty well. She's running for president, Ed, and her advisors are telling her that she needs to do something about the lack of sophistication, the lack of intellect, and the lack of worldliness. So she's latching on to big issues like Haiti.
Well, she has basically Twittered her way onto the political scene in this country, and some, I think, low-information voters have done a good job of just reading a couple of lines that she puts out there, thinking that they know exactly what the hell's going on in this country. But she's on the offensive, and here she is going after the GOP leadership in an interview with Barbara Walters.
The GOP wasn't close to winning the Senate. You know, they want to be known as such powerful characters, but they are impotent and limp, and they are weak. They hide behind somebody's skirts.
What do you make of that aggressive nature, Mike?
Well, as you watch her, it's that crazy card that comes out. And as soon as she told America that she could see Russia from her front porch, or that Putin might be planning an airborne invasion on Alaska, most Americans kind of understood that she wasn't funny in a ha-ha, giggle kind of way. She was funny in a very creepy kind of way. Look, she tells us she has a new schedule, and that is she's going to England and she's going to Israel. Chances nobody has told her when she goes to England that David Cameron, the Prime Minister of that of England, has made the statement that he thinks that she's dull and downright stupid. Maybe she can work through that on her visit to England, but it's going to take some major diplomatic training. She doesn't have it. Her handlers cannot make her look smart because she's not smart. 51% of the American public are on to this woman, and you know what? Every time she opens her mouth, we learn a little bit more about how creepy she really is. And this Haiti thing is just another one of those issues.
Can she create and will she create a faction within the Republican Party that could be problems for them down the road?
I think she's going to split it. Look, you got 22% of the American people that still have a favorable rating for her. Almost exclusively the Republicans. The people who understand what's happening here are very afraid of Palin because she understands what could happen at a convention. Yeah. That all the crazies will line up on one side of the room with Palin and all the moderates maybe on the other side of the room. It is a problem for Republicans. It's really not a problem for Democrats. And I think the more she's out there, the better it is for all of America because she is a Cook.
Mike Papantonio, always a pleasure. Good to have you with us tonight.